Welcome. NSG 423, Study Section 3, Curriculum Implementation and Evaluation. Introduction. In this study section, you will be exposed to the concept of curriculum implementation and evaluation. You will also be exposed to factors that influence curriculum implementation as well as curriculum evaluation. Learning outcomes. When you have studied this section, you should be able to define curriculum implementation and curriculum evaluation. List factors that influence curriculum implementation. Identify determinants of curriculum implementation. Distinguish among various forms of evaluation. Describe functions of curriculum evaluation. Definition of curriculum implementation. In the last study section, we learned about curriculum development theory and model. It is imperative to learn about curriculum implementation. Curriculum implementation entails putting into practice the officially prescribed courses of study, syllabus, and subjects. The process involves helping the learner acquire knowledge or experience. The learner is the central figure in the curriculum implementation process. Implementation takes place as the learner acquired the plan or intended experiences, knowledge, skills, idea, and attitude that are aimed at enabling the same learner to function effectively in a society. Viewed from this perspective, curriculum implementation also refers to the stage when the curriculum itself, as an educational program, is put into effect. Putting the curriculum into operation requires an implementing agent, the teacher. The curriculum implementation is the manner in which the teacher selects and mixes the various aspects of knowledge contained in a curriculum document or syllabus. Implementation takes place when the teacher constructed syllabus, the teacher's personality, the teaching materials, and the teaching environment interact with the learner. Curriculum implementation therefore refers to how the planned or officially designed course of study is translated by the teacher into syllabuses, schemes of work, and lessons to be delivered to students. Factors that influence curriculum implementation. The teacher. The teachers view their role in curriculum implementation as an autonomous one. They select and decide what to teach from the prescribed syllabus or curriculum. Since implementation takes place through the interaction of the learner and the planned learning opportunities, the role and influence of the teacher in the process is indisputable. The teacher must play a more significant role in designing the curriculum. Teachers must be involved in curriculum planning and development so that they can implement and modify the curriculum for the benefit of their learners. The learners. Learners are also a critical element in curriculum implementation. While teachers are the arbiters of the classroom practice, the learners hold the key to what is actually transmitted and adopted from the official curriculum. The official curriculum can be quite different from the curriculum that is actually implemented. The learner factor influences teachers in their selection of learning experiences. However, characteristic of learners in curriculum implementation. For example, home background and learner ability can determine what is actually achieved in the classroom. Resource, materials, and facilities. For the officially designed curriculum to be fully implemented as per plan, the government or Ministry of Education should supply schools with adequate resource materials such as textbooks, teaching aids, and stationery in order to enable teachers and learners to play their role satisfactorily in the curriculum implementation process. Governments must also provide physical facilities such as classrooms, laboratories, workshops, libraries, and sports fields in order to create an environment in which implementation can take place. The availability and quality of resource material and the availability of appropriate facilities have a great influence on curriculum implementation. Interest group. These include parents. Parents are teachers' association and school development committees, religious organizations, local authorities, companies, and private school proprietors. This group can influence implementation in the following ways. Provide schools with financial resources to purchase required material. Demand the inclusion of certain subjects in the curriculum. Influence learners to reject courses they consider detrimental to the interest of the group. It is therefore important to involve these groups at the curriculum planning stage. The school environment. Schools located in rich socio-economic environments and those that have adequate human and material resources can implement the curriculum to an extent that would be difficult or impossible for schools in poor economic environments. Culture and ideology. Cultural and ideological differences within a society or country can also influence curriculum implementation. Some communities may resist a domineering culture or government ideology and hence affect the implementation of the centrally planned curriculum. Instructional supervision. Curriculum implementation cannot be achieved unless it has been made possible through the supervisory function of the school head. The head does this through deploying staff, allocating time to subjects taught at the school, providing teaching and learning materials, and creating an atmosphere conducive to effective teaching and learning. Curriculum evaluation. Definitions of curriculum evaluation. The term curriculum evaluation has three major meanings. The process of describing and judging an educational program or subject. The process of comparing a student's performance with behaviorally stated objective. The process of defining, obtaining, and using relevant information for decision-making purposes. What you need to understand about these definitions is that each does not exist in isolation from the others, although each can be an activity on its own. The first activity involves the collection of descriptive and judgmental information for the purpose of establishing whether an educational program or project is doing what is expected to do. The evaluator pronounces judgment at the end of the exercise. The second activity involves comparing the performance of one or more students with set standards. Such an evaluation determines the extent to which the objective of a learning activity are being realized. This is the kind of evaluation teachers conduct on a daily basis. The third activity is concerned with the identification of deficiencies in an educational program or syllabus for the purpose of effecting revision and improvement. You are advised to note that curriculum evaluation exercises usually combine these three activities. Data is collected for passing judgment to identify deficiencies in program and to analyze programs in order to determine alternative or find appropriate intervention. Curriculum evaluation approaches. Five curriculum evaluation approaches have been identified. Bureaucratic evaluation, autocratic evaluation, democratic evaluation, normed referenced evaluation, criterion referenced evaluation, bureaucratic evaluation. This evaluation is usually initiated by government or the Ministry of Education. In your circumstances, the Ministry of Education could evaluate a course of study or subject taught in schools to find out whether they need improvement or modifications. The results of evaluation are used by the Ministry of Education or the government. Autocratic evaluation. This evaluation focuses on what is considered to be the educational needs of a curriculum. Government or ministry usually asks independent evaluators such as consultants, to conduct this evaluation. The government or ministry is not obliged to accept the result of the evaluation. Democratic evaluation. This focuses on the experience and reactions the curriculum initiator have had with the programs or projects being evaluated. In this approach, the evaluation does not lead to firm recommendations to be considered by the initiators or program implementers. Norm-referenced evaluation. This evaluates student performance relative to other students' performance. The performance of current students or of previous students can be compared. Criterion-referenced evaluation. Criterion referencing measures students' actual performance and compares it with the objective of instruction identified in the syllabus. Functions of curriculum evaluations are informing decision makers on the state of affairs of certain curriculum program or syllabus and enabling teachers to evaluate themselves. Decision making. The principal purpose of evaluation is to contribute to decision making. In our circumstances, curriculum evaluations are conducted in order to correct deficiencies, make improvements, and establish new priorities. For meaningful decisions to be made, they must be supported by evidence from evaluation exercise. Self-evaluation. This enables the teacher who is at the center of the evaluation exercise to examine himself. The advantage of self-evaluation is that it allows you to change the curriculum or instructional strategies if evaluation shows that they could be more effective. Focuses of evaluation. Evaluation generally focuses on the whole curriculum or aspects of it, such as objective, content, methodology, and outcome. Curriculum objective. These have to be evaluated because they are the foundation on which the curriculum program or project is frequently based. In order to conduct evaluations on objective, a number of questions must be asked. Are the objectives worthwhile? Can they be achieved? What are the expected outcomes? Also, objectives have to be evaluated because curriculum content, methodologies, and materials are designed to fit objectives. Teachers use curriculum objectives to guide classroom activities. Hence, the need for evaluation. Curriculum content and methodology. The content must be evaluated in order to establish whether it is relevant to the needs and aspirations of the society. When evaluating curriculum content, the focus should be on the effects it has on learners. It is important to determine whether the methodology is consistent with the curriculum objective and appropriate for the content. Curriculum outcomes. The evaluation of objective, content and methodology are conducted simultaneously as the evaluation of outcome. The purpose of this evaluation is to supply curriculum designers with information that can be used in improving the curriculum as a whole. Forms of evaluation. In the context of curriculum evaluation, there are formative and summative evaluations. Both can be conducted to provide information necessary for effective decision-making. Formative evaluation. The term formative evaluation was originally coined by Scrivener, 1973, to classify evaluation that gathered information for the purpose of improving instruction as the instruction was being given. The performance of the learner was the primary focus in Scrivener's version of formative evaluation. Information about the learner's immediate retention of skills and knowledge, retention over time, and attitude were used to shape instruction as it proceeded. Formative evaluation was considered to be an integral part of instructional design and delivery. In our curriculum context, formative evaluation can be considered to be the process that looks for evidence of success or failure of a curriculum program, a syllabus, or a subject taught during implementation. Formative evaluation Answer two questions. Is the instruction successful? If it is not successful, what can be done to avoid failure? It ensures that all aspects of the program or project are likely to produce success. It provides information that can be used to stop doubtful projects from being implemented. It is therefore a conceptual and physical exercise that is carried out before a program comes to an end. Summative evaluation. This type of evaluation assesses whether or not the project or program can perform as the originators and designers intended. It considers cost effectiveness in terms of money, time, and personnel. It also assesses the training that teacher might need in order to implement a program successfully. It determines whether a new curriculum program, syllabus, or subject is better than the one it is intended to replace or other alternatives. It is usually conducted at the end of the program cycle. Formative and summative evaluations can take place wherever an evaluation exercise is conducted. They can be conducted on educational projects and programs existing in the curriculum or on the teaching of individual subjects in the school systems. Evaluation methods and tools. A variety of methods and tools can be used to conduct evaluations, including the following: observations, interviews, tests, questionnaires. The observation, interview, and questionnaire techniques can be used when evaluating the entire curriculum as well as specific curriculum programs or projects. One technique that is usually used to evaluate the outcome of curriculum program is subjecting students to structured tests. Student academic performance is usually evaluated by using this technique. Also, the content of a subject matter can be evaluated by testing students in its various content area. Results from this type of evaluation are given to curriculum designers to enable them to review the subject area affected and make necessary changes and improvements. Study section summary. In this study section, we outline some of the factors that influence the implementation of a curriculum and discuss how each factor influences the implementation process. In educational practice, these factors interact with each other and generate influences that cannot be attributed to one factor or another. You should view them as a whole. It has also helped to understand what is meant by curriculum evaluation, the unit defined curriculum evaluation, and describe some approaches to these activities, which include bureaucratic, autocratic, democratic, norm reference, and criterion reference evaluation. The concept of formative and summative evaluation were also explained briefly. Now we've come to the end of the study section. Thanks for listening.